Kenali Vivi Yusof, pemilik Fashion Ballet dengan lebih mesra. Mengorak langkah ke alam perniagaan pada usia muda, berbekalkan kecekalan dan dedikasi, Vivi belajar untuk berdiri di atas kaki sendiri. Penat lelahnya berhasil apabila perniagaan yang diusulkan dengan keringatnya kini menjadi empire fashion yang disegani. Macam-macam cabaran yang dihadapi dalam rutin sehariannya. Dari potensi kehilangan seorang breaker fashion kepada pesaing sampailah terlupa ambil anak. Saksikan bagaimana Vivi mengendalikan kerjayanya dan keluarga tercinta. Mampukah Vivi mengimbangi kedua-duanya?
Nama saya Kim Kardashian. Nama saya Vivi Yusof. Saya dengan suami saya mengendalikan sebuah syarikat Fashion Ballet. So kami ialah online portal yang menjual rekaan breaker fashion seluruh Asia. Morning.
Morning, how are you?
Good. I'm on the way.
I'm in the office already.
The team semua dah ada?
Most people are here. A few people still on the way, I think.
Yeah, okay. Can you get anything in?
Yeah, no, I really want a drink. Can you get me a drink and that sugar donut thing that I like?
Okay, I'll get that for you.
See you there.
Okay,
bye.
Most of the time, I'm running after her. Dia tertinggal phone ke, belum makan ke, dia running late ke.
So, setiap pagi memang saya terburu-buru dengan anak-anak semua dengan husband.
So, my job is to get her where she needs to go, looking the best she needs to be. I'm just helping her with not running her life.
Memang tak ada time langsung nak makan breakfast, which is very bad. Tapi nasib baik saya ada Iman sebab saya suruh dia beli the sugar donut that I like and my drink. Kesian dia.
Fashion Ballet ditubuhkan 5 tahun lepas. Masa tu kita lah yang pertama sekali start kat Malaysia online shopping for fashion. Saya dengan suami saya dua-dua belajar dekat London dulu dan kami diperkenalkan dengan online shopping culture. So bila balik Malaysia lepas dah belajar, kita rasa macam oh tak ada lagi kat sini online shop for designers. So we thought okay, kita buat. Why don't we try? Bila saya fikir balik time dulu and how susah it was, I'm just so glad that I never gave up. Masa kita launch tu, hanya ada 10 jenama join Fashion Ballet. Dan sekarang dah 5 tahun kemudian, kita dah ada office dekat Singapore, dekat Jakarta, dekat KL. Dan kita dah ada 80 orang, over 400 brands. I'm very proud of where Fashion Ballet is. I know exactly tiap-tiap hari apa meeting-meeting saya hari ini. Tapi of course lah, macam hari ini ada ad hoc meeting. So today kita ada meeting dengan whole of head of departments. Okay, so today I want to talk about raya. Sebab planning raya ni is not 1 month, 2 months. It's early of the year. We have to work months ahead. In terms of finance,
yeah, memang budget cukup lah. Because I already spoke to Jaja. What we have is still like it's all within budget. What I do, Fashion Ballet, dengan jaga the budget. All the departments, if they want to buy apa, then they will submit the budget to me, and then I will then see whether we have the sufficient finance for it to approve accordingly lah.
Okay, Lisa, in terms of orders fulfillment, last year memang banyak problem.
Yeah, and we'll try to eliminate those problems this year. Yeah,
need to put your team together and buat sistem from A to Z. Mm-mm. Macam mana nak buat efficient, macam nak buat cepat. Cepat and tak ada salah.
Yes. Yeah. I really have the most team yang saling membantu sesama sendiri. Is the fulfillment team. There is Shikin and Aiman and the rest of the girls. They're all downstairs based at the warehouse. We all work together.
So kita orang have GKN kita bincangkan gaya tengah, yes. Yeah. And then kita akan belikan billboard first. So we attack the billboard first, and then we go.
So on the billboard tu nak
tunjuk? No. It's just brand awareness. Okay. So like high traffic areas. So like they sort of know about us before you go to that station, to that venues lah.
I tengah busy sekarang ni with my team is Gaya Koleksi Raya. It's one of the biggest fashion show for Raya lah. Semua designers will be in it. Kita tengah buat calculation for billboards sebab kita akan pergi 4 states to buy billboards.
Working in FV is like working with a big family. So it's different from the other corporate company.
Do not to share.
Habis ready. You have to
close.
Well, as you can see, our office, we have like, you can duduk wherever you want lah. Like, I don't sit at my desk most of the time. I always sit at the pantry because, you know, aside from food, it's calming over there.
HR, we need a lot of people, Masa Raya. We need interns, we need part-time workers.
Drivers.
Yes.
Nak ambil baju, nak ambil kasut, yeah. Whatever. And there will be like urgent cases yang macam kita kena hantar ke rumah customer yang mana nak balik kampung that day kind of thing.
Yeah? Okay. Sekarang ni what KHR is busy on is preparing for Raya. Kita kena cari lagi banyak tenaga kerja lah untuk tolong kita masa Raya.
Okay, so thank you guys. So I just wanted to make sure kita semua on top of Raya this year. We do it really, really good. Yes?
Yes.
Go team.
Daniel?
What time is it?
Your son?
Oh my god!
Saya dah sedia dah dengan date saya hari ni. Tapi tiba-tiba Jaja pula cakap, ada satu designer kita ni dah nak join competitor. This happens a lot, you know. Biasalah, business mana yang tak ada competitors always trying to take what you have.
Okay, so now kita nak pergi designer punya showroom. We want to talk to her sebab dia kita ada masalah sikit ni.
Okay, so kita kena cakap kat dia, not just about money. It's about marketing, you know. We're going to go overseas. We're going to bring your brand overseas. Come with us. You know, at the end of the day, kita yang the place for local brands.
At first, dia cakap dia tak boleh produce for us. I macam, what do you mean?
She's very hardworking. Dia memang akan turun padang. Kalau ada problem benda-benda yang urgent yang kena settle, dia akan buat time tu juga.
Vivi adalah seorang yang tegas.
If there's something you know she wants to get, she will go get it.
Dia just superwoman lah, basically. She's like really hands-on. Apa yang dia buat memang dia ada passion.
Hi, Ming.
Hi.
You're on the way to designer, kan?
Yeah, I'm going to her showroom.
Do you remember this person called Daniel?
What time is it?
Your son?
Oh my god, dia balik sekolah.
Saya lupa ambil dia kat sekolah.
Oh my god. I have Mizan with me. Okay, nama I call my mom. Kejap.
Okay.
Bye. Thanks. God, I forgot to pick up my son.
Nasib baik, saya call mak saya, tolonglah mami, tolong ambil Daniel. I mean, that happens sometimes and it's really bad. But itulah working mom kan, sometimes you have to juggle and you're a bit overwhelmed. You lupa one or the other. You need to have a support system. So nasib baik saya ada hari ni mak saya tolong saya.
So kita orang dah jumpa designer and dah cakap pasal fashion value punya marketing plan and what we plan to do for her. Sebenarnya biasalah dalam bisnes ni kita mesti ada competition kan. So of course competitors will come and take what you have already. And the key is to not burukkan them but just see what you can offer better. So we did that tadi. So let's just see the outcome lah, whether she chooses us or she goes with our competitor.
So lepas butik tu saya balik office, saya continue lah discuss dengan department by department. That's my daily work life. Saya always in touch dengan my team to know what's going on, everyday punya issue. Saya check komen dalam Instagram, ada tak masalah, mungkin customer tak dapat order ke dan kenapa. So I'm always here in touch with everyone. The Amelia, kenapa the second picture is the same picture? The second picture is the same photo.
Hari ni after work
I have high tea plan for my family dekat my house.
Saya ada full day kat office and I terlupa sangat that I ajak my parents to come to have tea kat my house. And pandai-pandai ajak tapi tak tahu nak prepare apa-apa.
So cepat-cepat saya pergi supermarket dengan Iman.
Daripada kerja office sampai ke supermarket pun dia akan ada dengan I. Thank you, Iman.
Every step of the way.
Every step. The
saya call mak saya in the car.
Waalaikumsalam, Mami. Okay, Mami, I need help.
Nasib baiklah ada mak.
Bibi terlupa that you guys are coming over. So I'm going to buy the ingredients. What if we make like spaghetti?
Gathering ni memang biasa kita lakukan. Almost every week kadang pun kan.
Actually, Bibi dah text Santiman tadi dah pukul 10 lebih. Kata mak, tomorrow Bibi kerja half day. Bibi nak buat high tea. Gather all the family. Daddy's coming, Mommy coming, Along.
Bagi saya, family time tu penting. And Alhamdulillah, adik saya ni jenis yang mementingkan family time dia. Kalau kita tak datang tu, nanti dia marah.
Pergi kat supermarket, cepat-cepat saya beli apa-apa ingredients. Ada yang tak cukup tapi tak apalah, belas sajalah. Okay, so kita dah beli pun barang apa semua yang my mom suruh beli tu. Ada pepper, ada parsley, ada garlic, semua ada. So, we can go back now. My mom datang, my mak mertua datang. And then, thank God my dad tak sampai lagi. So, kita pun cepat-cepat masak. Okay, saya dah tukar baju dah, ready nak masak. I have my mother-in-law here and my mom.
Hello.
Sebenarnya, I nak masak untuk diorang. Tapi, I panggil diorang awal. So, strategi I, diorang yang masak sebenarnya. I tengok je. So I memang kenalah. Oh, tak pandai potong ni lah. Mana periuk tak cukup, mana senduk ni tak ada. Biasalah kita tak pandai masak kan. Terselah I punya kekurangan di kitchen.
If you cry, I do this, okay? Boy, don't cry.
Oh yes.
Ini tapi you.
Yes.
Besar
tu. Besar ada tu. Oh ni.
Tu tiga dua orang.
Nampak sangat tak tak masak kat rumah.
Itulah lain kali atok.
That's nice. At least I got to spend time dengan my mom and mother-in-law. And I memang rasa bertuah sangat sebab tak ramai yang mak dengan mak mertua boleh klik.
Dah betul ke bawah tu, Kak Isha? Dah betul bawah dia?
Betul lah.
Itu
nak
kerja tak biasa lagi.
Mak,
kenapa? Hey. Vivi ni boleh manja tau.
Kata nakal tak lah. Bukan nakal in a negative way.
Manja macam bit childish lah.
Dia mischievous sikit kan, ceria.
Dia kau jumpa nanti duduk atas apa lah. Nak suruh peluk-peluk lah macam tu.
Dan tu kalau dia nak sesuatu tu, dia mesti cuba akan dapatkan juga.
Nanti jangan lupa nak ambil gambar ya.
Dalam tu kot, dalam tu.
Tomato kat bawah tu, Mak. Sekejap, Bibi tengah ambil gambar ni, tengah sibuk. Tengok gambar yang ambil. Kenapa cantik?
Let's
saya dah punya dua orang anak, Vivi dengan kakaknya. Dua-duanya sama saja kita beri pengetahuan nilai ataupun tertuan nilai-nilai yang baik. Kan?
Nampak ya? Hai, dah semua dah. Danny! Hai! You are here.
Keluarga saya positif. Kita tak ada nak cakap makit pagi nak bergaduh apa, tak ada. Kita positif. Kita bercakap yang baik. Yang dengan keluarga tak ada nak marah, tak ada nak bergaduh. Kan? It's positive. Because positive itu memberi kita energy. Positif juga kan, menjadi kita kuat.
Mami's cooking.
Api dia macam tu.
Really?
I risk my life. Janganlah, sedap. Sedap, try it. I have two plates already.
Kalau Vivi rebellious, dia berani ambil risiko. Ada kita jangan buat itu, dia nak buat juga. Cerdik. Yang budak cerdik. Somebody who wants fun, dia boleh bekerja dalam team. Dalam keluarga saya, saya run my family like a company.
If you don't have a relationship among your family, you are bound, you know, not to be happy.
Yes.
And when you're not happy, you're not be healthy. Right? Why is the boy crying?
Salah satu nilai itu, dia orang ni kalau dengan saya, they cannot cry. To me, I don't train my kid to cry. Saya tak mahu dia orang nangis. Saya beritahu dia orang nangis, tak boleh menyelesaikan masalah.
What happened? Hey,
ini Mika, softy. Daniel?
Daniel,
you cry, I do this. Okay? Boy, don't cry. Only so girls cry. Boy has to be strong.
Are you
don't
strong? Cry.
Show one daddy a big muscle.
Show one daddy a muscle.
Fazal dan Vivi ni bagi saya diorang satu pasangan yang sangat dinamik.
I kira dia orang ni entrepreneur, sanggup ambil risiko yang lebih.
Cuma nanti selalu terapkan pada Vivi, please stand where you are. Jangan kita terlampau meninggi diri, apa. Just be who yourself.
Fashion Valley kan tempat yang kita grow dengan designers, local designers. So memang orang tahu kalau nak shop dekat Fashion Valley, you will get pretty fashion tempatan yang best-best. AG Azman is one talented designer yang memang saya suka.
Of course, when a designer punya nama lagi besar, e-commerce is very competitive. Saya ada competitor yang we are like sharks, you know, we want the same designer. Kalau saya rasa designer tu ada potensi and very good, of course saya akan fight for the designer.
My collection yang second ni ada competitors from Fashion Valley punya competitors. I got the offer. They offer me benda yang something yang maybe I tak dapat from FV. Beritahu Jaja, I cakap maybe this Raya collection I tak dapat nak join diorang. Tu yang diorang pun rushing datang macam nak talk kan, macam how come macam ni kan. So from there lah. I think it's time lah I beritahu dengan competitors tu yang macam I tak dapat join, and then I stick to MV. So I reply email Jaja, I cakap I think I'm going to stay with MV. Baru Jaya send, sekali I dapat WhatsApp daripada Jaja. Jaja macam, EG, I receive your email. And macam, yay, dia jumpa kan.
Jaja yang beritahu saya yang EG chose Fashion Valley. So saya masa tu saya baca WhatsApp Jaja, saya macam, hi! Tapi kena cool. So biasa dia Jaja, dah tahu Fashion Valley-nya. Setiap raya, saya dengan buying team saya akan jumpa Rika Fashion and di boutique mereka, dan mereka akan tunjukkan koleksi sample presentation lah, their raya presentation to us. Dan sekarang saya di boutique AG Azman untuk tengok dia punya 2016 raya collection.
Brand ni dah start 2 years ago. Habis study tu baru balik, then EG approach Fashion Valley untuk start my business online lah.
Of course, every designer concern dia dua. One is sales and the second one is marketing.
So what can we do to improve their sales and what can we do to improve their marketing? Itulah yang saya selalu brainstorm dengan buying team, marketing team, macam mana kita nak naikkan nama-nama designer, because we are known to be the place for local designers.
Tak boleh je. This one nampak everything.
Yeah.
Nampak ketiak dia semua kalau
kan juga, because mostly FK punya buyer is Muslim.
Yeah, and it's raya. So raya kan orang. How about we add the sleeves? Because semua yang lain dah macam perfect dah. The peplum, the tulip
yeah,
cut, the
add sleeves.
Yeah. Pasal raya collection ni, of course kita kena tahu customer kita siapa. Customer kita mostly orang Melayu. Raya kita kena pakai sopan. Walaupun you berhijab ke tak berhijab ke, you will still have to look decent and modest. So that's why I selalu advise designers, kalau raya collection, keep it long sleeve. So orang yang berhijab pun boleh pakai, orang yang tak berhijab pun boleh pakai. Casual, non-raya collection, then you can do whatever you want. But for raya, keep it to the norm.
Satu yang paling I convince is sebab diorang pun dah nak try marketkan brand FV to Singapore, Indonesia, Brunei, so international goes international, and they will bring my brand pergi sana juga. Tu yang lagi I rasa confident, and then they have store dekat Bangsa Village. So I think people boleh pergi rasa baju tu sendiri macam mana, tengok buat designer punya fashion show semua untuk orang kenal my brand lagi.
Masa kecil dulu, cita-cita saya sebenarnya nak jadi cashier. Tak sangka rezeki saya di bidang fashion pula. Sememangnya perjalanan hidup ni suatu ketentuan Tuhan yang cukup misteri. Saya bersyukur dianugerahkan keluarga yang amat memahami. Tanpa sokongan dan kasih sayang mereka, siapalah Vivi Yusof. Merekalah segala-galanya buat saya. Love, Vivi.
Kita pun dapat peluang nak cakap pasal Mariam punya hari jadi pertama. It's very special. Okay, apa team yang kita nak buat?
I think we just do the small party just at the restaurant.
Don't you love her?